At last this day is over. Now I can finally sit down and find some quiet. How many of you feel like that right now? I welcome you to the program Night Sounds. I'm Bill Pearce. Quietness. Just to get away from the surface hostility and noise, clamor of the environment, perhaps where you work, in your home, even in your soul and spirit and mind. I'm thinking right now of a beautiful scripture verse found in the Old Testament. It's very brief, but it sets the platform from which we work tonight. Isaiah chapter 30, verse 15. In quietness and confidence shall be your strength. On tonight's program, I'm going to single out that word quietness, and in this entire 28 minutes, I'm going to play one song, various interpretations of it. The song title is There Is a Quiet Place, Far from the Rapid Pace, where God can soothe the troubled mind. Sheltered by tree and flower, there in my quiet hour with Him, my heart is lifted. In the first rendition tonight, the 102 strings, conducted by the writer of this song, Ralph Carmichael, to help calm us, soothe our spirits, so that the final phrase of the song can come true. Then, from this quiet place, I go, prepared to face a new day with love for all mankind. So tonight I hope that you're able to just relax, sit back, lie back, and listen to the quiet. Tonight, as we hear various renditions of this particular song, I'm going to be reading poetry that speaks of confidence, quietness, strength. From the book Kneeling in Jerusalem, poetess Anne Weems wrote, "Holy is the time. Holy and quiet is this place. And there are holy things that must be said. Let us say to one another what our souls whisper. O Holy One, cast your tent among us. Come into our ordinary lives and bless the living. Let us say to one another what our souls whisper. 40 days stretch before us. 40 days of hungering after faithfulness. 40 days of trying to understand the story. And then Holy Week. Oh God, if every week were holy, these 40 days stretch before us, and those of us who believe yearn to feel your presence, yearn to be your people. And yet the days fill with ordinary things, sounds, with no time left for seeking the holy. Spiritual contemplation is all right for those who have the time. But most of us have to make a living. Most of us have to live in the real world where profanity splashes and blots out anything holy. Where, O Holy One, can we find you in this squalid, noisy, unholy mess? How, O God, can we find the holy in the ordinary? In tonight's program, A Quiet Place, we seek to find the quietness of heart, the peace of soul and spirit, not in any man-made structures or philosophies, but through His holy word. Let's look at Job, a man who was tossed about in his soul and spirit. In Job chapter 37, verse 15, the words, "Do you know how God controls the clouds and makes His lightning flash? Do you know how the clouds hang poised? Those wonders of Him who is perfect in knowledge. You who swelter in your clothes when the land lies quiet under the south wind. Tell us what we should say to Him. Should He be told that I want to speak?" And tonight, often there is so much speaking that we forget to be quiet. Once again, Isaiah 30, verse 15, "In quietness and confidence shall be your strength." In our program, A Quiet Place, as I mentioned at the outset of our time together, I'm playing one song with various renditions. That song is also the title of our time, A Quiet Place. Shortly after the song was written, I had the privilege of recording this with the Stockholm Symphony string section and some woodwinds, conducted by Kurt Kaiser, solo trombone, once again striking on the beautiful song, A Quiet Place. Let's just allow our souls to be soothed, calmed, and quieted by God's Holy Spirit right now. solo trombone, strings, and woodwinds. The song A Quiet Place. I'm turning now to Psalm chapter 107, beginning at verse 24. They saw the works of the Lord, His wonderful deeds in the deep. For He spoke and stirred up a tempest that lifted high the waves. They mounted up to the heavens and went down to the depths. In their peril, their courage melted away. They reeled and staggered like drunken men. They were at their wits' end. Then they cried out to the Lord in their trouble, and He brought them out of their distress. He stilled the storm to a whisper. The waves of the sea were hushed. They were glad when it grew quiet. And He guided them to their desired haven. Let them give thanks to the Lord for His unfailing love. Just a few minutes before coming into the studio tonight, ironically, I received a telephone call from California. It was Ralph Carmichael, the one who wrote the song we're playing, and he asked, "Have you received the CD I sent?" It's a recording of big band interpretations of many of the songs that he's written in past years. And I said, "Yes, Ralph, thank you so much. It was expertly performed." And then he asked, "Is there anything that you could use on Night Sounds?" So I responded, "Well, I don't know. You've got about 10 brass and 6 woodwinds and 4 or 5 rhythm there. Pretty hard to subdue all those vibrant musicians to fit it into the Night Sounds format." He said, "Well, what about A Quiet Place?" I thought, "Well, that's about the quietest one on the album. And if I can find the right setting for it, I'd be glad to play it. In fact, I'd be honored." So here we go. This is a big band rendition. The composer himself conducting A Quiet Place. I think in our conversation on the phone, Ralph Carmichael and I were talking about this particular album and the renditions on it of the big band music. So I said, "If it gets a little too rambunctious, Ralph, I may have to bring it under and read some poetry." He said, "Okay with me." So I think we'll do that right now with a tenor. Sax plays a little bit of improvisation in the background. Turning to the verse poetry of Helen Steiner Rice. She writes, "You're worried and troubled about everything, wondering and fearing what tomorrow will bring. You long to tell someone, for you feel so alone. But your friends are all burdened with cares of their own. There is only one place and only one friend who was never too busy. And you can always depend that he will be waiting with arms open wide to hear all your troubles that you came to confide. For the Heavenly Father will always be there when you seek him and find him in quietness at the altar of prayer. Coming up to the final few measures of the Song of Quiet Place with the big band, Ralph Carmichael directing. In our program, Night Sounds, concentrating on this particular number all the way through with various styles and renditions. I'm Bill Pearce, and Night Sounds comes your way just about every night at this time on the station. I'm so honored to have you there, and I look forward to this every night. There's something special, unique, and distinctive about every time we meet like this. And I can't count the thousands upon thousands of programs we've done. Thank you for being there, for listening, for sharing, for responding, for absorbing, for your input, because many of you do. Right. Let me know who you are, where you are, what's happening. Some of you send materials that we read on the air. Others send a little bit of constructive criticism now and then, and I can always take that. Some suggestions. Many of you level with me. Some ventilate. Air the worries, the griefs. Thank you for this kind of intimacy. We want to uphold one another's burdens, so fulfilling the law of Christ. And we try to do so in quietness, confidence, and contentment in the Spirit of God to draw us, to polarize us together, to exalt Jesus Christ. This is our design and our intent. And after we go off the air, such other ministries of Night Sounds as the music, some of which you heard already from the album Encore, trombone solos, with vocal renditions and other forms of musical expression. The series that we've recorded on various subjects, such as the fruit of the Spirit, dealing with our emotions, relationships, from defeat to victory, a series on love, loneliness, grief, depression. All of these are series of 8 programs to each subject in a very distinctive Night Sounds binder. If you'd like more information, our mailing address is Night Sounds, Wheaton, Illinois, 60189. And returning once again to the title of our program tonight, as well as the principal song involved, A Quiet Place. From the pen of Joy Morgan Davis, this work entitled Be Still, My Soul. You have performed many miracles in my life, Lord, especially during these last few days. What I had thought would be rough has been smooth. What I had thought would be narrow has been wide. And what I feared would cause my collapse has become, instead, my foundation. How I dreaded the yoke and rebelled at the burden. But I found the yoke is easy and the burden is light. And once more you have proved that the impossible can be. When will I learn that whatever you choose, wherever you lead, there and there only is my peace and my prosperity? When will my soul simply rest and wait on thee? And tonight in our program, we're featuring one song. The song being the title of our time together, A Quiet Place. Turning now to a vocal group who call themselves Take Six. Four men. Not just a quartet, but their harmonizations and interpretations are electric. Almost impossible to sing. Yet, once again, they treat, in their own stylistic fashion, our song, A Quiet Place.
From this quiet place, I go prepared to face new day with love for all mankind.
Turning now to the pianistic artistry of Kurt Kaiser as he plays our final rendition of A Quiet Place. Leona Choi wrote the work titled Silence. The house is quiet with an unaccustomed hush. I never knew that the clock ticked so loudly. I listen intently to hear what? No familiar voice, no happy daily noises, only silence. No, I don't sense him near. For he is not here, his chair is empty, his glasses laid aside, his books unread. The things we did together, I do alone. I laugh alone. I cry alone. I learn to live alone. But he hasn't just vanished, he is elsewhere, more alive than ever. Savoring his exciting new state, experiencing endless life and joy. It is I who am left behind alone for a while. Once again, we come to the conclusion of our time together tonight. Heavenly Father, thank you for the quietness and the confidence of your Spirit. We pray that we might be quiet Even if silence brings unhappy, troubling memories, we can fill that void with joy, knowing that you love us, that you have rescued us through the Lord Jesus Christ, to whom we commit these moments, the coming night and the day tomorrow. Amen. And once again, I want to thank you for being right where you are tonight. Hope you've enjoyed the music, the words, poetry, and prayer. If we can be of any help to you further, this is our intent. Please write us. Our mailing address is Nightsounds, Wheaton, Illinois, 60189. And may his quietness and confidence and strength be your experience through the night and into tomorrow. Until next time, a peaceful and quiet good night.